All right, Dave Schultz, back live from the Sun Belt Media Days in New Orleans, Louisiana. Cody Schutz holding down the fort at the ShopRite Tobacco Plus Studios, Palatial Studios at Delta Media Corporation. We're powered by Pete's in Lafayette and Metter's Kitchen Equipment. We are live with the head coach of the Ragin' Cajuns football team, Billy Napier. Your first Media Days, and like you said, when you start holding Media Days, it's time to play football. Let's talk about football. How is the health of your team going into camp?
Well, I'm excited about the progress. A lot of those guys that maybe were limited in spring ball, you know, certainly all the guys that we had with shoulders have made tremendous progress. Corey Turner, Cole Prudhomme, Justin Middleton, all those guys are back to full speed and will be ready to participate like all the other players in training camp. Some of the lower body guys are ready to go. Raheem Malone, you know, he'll be 100%, but we'll keep him non-contact for a while. We'll get him back. You know, Trey Regis was a little bit nicked up at the end of the spring, but he's been healthy for a long time. Really, the only issues that we have that are pressing is Chase Rogers obviously will be out for the year with the broken foot, which is kind of a lingering issue from the prior year. And then Joe Dillon with the hip injury that he had last year. A lot of research went into that this year. I think we've got that figured out and certainly appreciate the people in Birmingham helping us out with that. So Joe will redshirt as well, most likely. And those guys will be around, but they'll obviously be limited in terms of their ability to contribute to the team.
And then what about Stevie Arteague and Elijah Mitchell?
Stevie's out. Stevie tore his knee in a non-football-related activity. We have Calvin Linden, obviously, in competition there with a new addition to our team that we'll be able to announce at some point. I'm excited about that part as well. So we'll have competition in all of our specialist positions, you know, whether that's punter, long snapper, or kicker, which is one of the things that we've got to figure out and get to the bottom of. So, but certainly Elijah Mitchell has made really good progress here lately. He's back into team activities with the rest of the team. He's pain-free and has been here for 4 or 5 weeks. We've had really good work and kind of a team effort with our strength and conditioning staff, our training staff, and our physical therapy people in town. So I'm pleased with the progress that Elijah's made, and I think he would say the same thing if he was here today.
We're live at the Sun Belt Media Days with the head coach of the Ragin' Cajuns, Billy Napier, on Acadiana Sports Station. 103.7 The Game, 103.7thegame.com. Powered by Pete's and Metter's Kitchen Equipment. It's a Monday morning sports chat. All right, what phase are we in now? I can't keep track.
Well, we're still trying to finish strong in summer. Certainly, we've got about a week and a half left of work to do, not only with our football team, but with our staff. You know, so our staff reports today, and our players report on August the 2nd. But we still need to finish strong here right at the end. You know, we've got a second conditioning test coming up. We've got several opportunities in OTAs with our team. So we need to stay focused on the work that's at hand here the next week and a half, and then when we report on August the 2nd, we'll be ready to go for training camp.
One of the things that I don't think Mark Cutsmith ever figured out, and I'm not sure there's a right way to do it, was having the team ready and rested but in shape come the season. A couple of times he was playing Arkansas and Kansas State, and he thought he worked them too hard because he was getting ready to play SEC and Big 12. What is your plan here in camp? When do you plan on holding practice?
Well, we're gonna practice at every opportunity that we have. You know, and certainly the new structure for training camp, basically everybody gets about 25 practice opportunities. You're allowed to practice 6 out of 7 days. You know, you're required to give the guys an off day where basically you can meet with them for 2 hours, but there's no football activity on that day. But we've got a training camp structure. I've spent a lot of time talking with some of my close friends in the business in terms of how they've adjusted the typical training camp schedule that we've used in the past, whether that's Alabama, Tennessee, Georgia, Florida Atlantic, Oregon. So
it may be different, say maybe one thing for the first 2 weeks and then maybe something different for the last 2 weeks.
Well, not necessarily. I mean, we basically, we've got a install that we go through. You know, we introduce all the down and distances, all the field zones. We work toward 2 scrimmages, basically on Saturdays. And then we, at some point we'll flip the page to the first team that we play in the season, which is Grambling. and we'll start preparing our team. You know, so everybody's schedule is a little bit different because of when school starts, certainly when you open the season. Some people spend different amount of times on the first team. But we've got a good plan. It's very similar to what we've used in the past.
All right, well, let's ask the big question. I'm not sure what kind of answer we're going to get, but when do you – let's answer it this way. When would you like to have a starting quarterback? Whether you tell us or not is one thing, but in your own mind and the team, when is somebody going to get the first team reps? How long do you think that'll take?
Well, it'll be very obvious to not only our staff but our players, you know, and I think, you know, whenever that may be halfway through training camp, one guy really – separates himself from the other guy, but it's going to be a competition, you know, and obviously there's lots to unfold, and this is one of the competitive battles that we have on our team. I mean, we've got great quality depth at tons of positions. We've got a huge group of newcomers on defense. I mean, there's tons of position battles to talk about, and quarterback certainly is in that conversation, but the good thing is I think we have two good players. If we had to play either one of these guys, I would sleep good the night before the game. And that is definitely a positive. You know, we could have no quarterbacks. You know, so
you have plenty of running backs.
Yeah, we do. We've got quality depth at our skill positions. I think that's one of the strengths of our team. I'm pleased with the receiver group and the running back group in terms of the number of players that we have that I think can play winning football. And I think that's what's going to allow us an opportunity to really press those guys to do it the way we want it done. You know, and play the young men that are, you know, making improvement, competing each day, making a legitimate effort to learn, improve, and compete, and certainly showing the toughness that we want out of those groups. So we've got lots of strengths and certainly lots of questions to answer as we approach the opener.
Well, let's flip the script. Let's talk about the defense, because that was the issue. 2 years ago, this was an outstanding defense, but the offense couldn't get going. Last year, the offense was explosive, but the defense couldn't stop anybody. And you got a couple of guys you got to replace, a Joe Dillon, a Tracy Walker. Who are we looking for on the defensive side to step up?
Well, the interesting dynamic for us is we've added 15 scholarship players to the defensive side of the ball since we got the job, you know. And we've moved three offensive players from defense to offense. I mean, from offense to defense. So I think we've made an effort there to improve the personnel. And I think our defensive staff's also done a really good job of installing our concepts and putting together a plan that these guys can execute. So we had a great opportunity to introduce all the concepts in the spring and get a feel for our personnel. I'm excited to see what direction we go there in terms of putting the players in the best positions. And trying to be difficult to prepare for in a three-day, you know, turnaround within the season. So the huge headliner is 15 new scholarship players, three offensive players, Mike Jacquette being the headliner at corner. But I think we've answered a lot of the questions. And I think some of the areas where maybe we had issues, we've really improved. So, and that's a direct reflection of the quality coaching staff we put together on that side of the ball.
All right, let's wrap it up here with Billy Napier, their head coach of the Ragin' Cajuns football team, live from the 2018 Sun Belt Media Days, powered by Pete's and Metter's Kitchen Equipment. Heck of an article in Sports Illustrated. I still can't get over the $0 to $1.5 million budget for the snacks. It didn't go from $6 to $7.50. It went from $0 to $1.5. You talk about the plans with all the different colleges and the coaches that you talked to, but talked about how your phases are reflected in your father, Bill.
Well, I think, you know, at the core of who I am and why I coach, it goes back to just growing up, observing it every day, you know, and certainly that's what's exciting about this time of the year is, you know, you go through these same processes when you play on a high school team, when you're a player in college, and certainly as I've got into the coaching profession. But, you know, I think going about my business a certain way is what Dad would be putting an emphasis on, you know, and representing the family and what we were about. And certainly, you know, I think the way you coach players, the trust and respect that you're trying to establish with those guys, I think if they have a sincere if they know you have a sincere approach and that you're really interested in them making progress and having success, you can coach them really hard and be demanding, and certainly that's what we try to do. We try to define the expectations and hold them accountable. And I think that's why my dad had success. He was consistent, he was fair, and certainly that's why we want our program to be run.
Any chances of other Napiers joining you on your staff down the road somewhere?
Well, I've got, you know, I think one of my brothers might be in that market, you know, but he's not quite ready. But certainly, as we get going, there'll be opportunities for him to grow and mature. And certainly at some point, if there's a role that I feel like he fits, that could happen for sure.
All right, Billy Napier, we're looking forward to the season. Don't overlook Grambling. It's going to be a heck of a matchup. I think it's the first time that UL and Grambling have ever played. They're the champs last year. They're picked to be the champs this year. It's going to be a good first game.
Well, it's certainly, and that's good for our football team. You know, when you play a conference champ, you play a team that's really made improvement over the last couple of years, and their staff's done a good job, and certainly their head coach has really provided some stability there. And you can see on the tape, they're a team that plays with great effort. And they've got a good team coming back. So it'll be a challenge. And with our football team and the dynamic we have, every week is going to be critical. And in this league we play in, certainly with our non-conference schedule, I mean, that's going to be the case every week. So we'll have to have our team ready to go. And, you know, I think that's the case in most of college football these days. There's so much parity. But we got lots of work to do between now and then, and that's where our focus is right now.
All right, we'll be back. More from Sunbelt Media Days live in the New Orleans Superdome on Acadiana Sports Station. 103.7 The Game, 103.7thegame.com, powered by Pete's and Metters Kitchen Equipment.